When I came back to Burma, 88, there's also the People's War movement, huh? People demonstrated. When U Ne Win said he's going to retire because he don't want to hang on in politics, he just want to quit. But he want to know the desire of the people, whether people want democracy or people still want one-party system. And then people just walk out and demonstrate that. Huh? But in Burma, it is totally a handful of military regimes, huh? the leaders and the opposition and the people. When this happened, the people movement in Burma happened. You see, all the people just walk out, demonstrated on the street and walking as demanding or asking for change. Huh? They want democracy, they want a multi-party system. And many soldiers, no? From the Navy, from the Air Force, from the Army, they join the people. The People Power Movement in Burma, there's no leader. There's no opposition as yet at the time. When U Ne Win called for the people, he want to know whether people want democracy or want one-party system. People just walk out. There's no leader, huh? No opposition. I was in Rangoon. Yeah, I know everything. even when the thing started with the killing of one of the students at RIT. RIT is very close to our seminary in Insein. It's only a block away. So we are very close. We hear everything, even shooting, and even many of our students went there. And I'm only the only man teacher in the seminary then. So I was asked also to look after these students. You know. Many times I went there to the demonstration, the site where this thing's happening. I saw everything. But in Burma, it is totally people against the military. Eh? And there's no opposition leader. There's no outside, the military or power or something like the Americans or any other foreign presence in Burma. It's totally people against the military, some of the regimes, no? The military government at the time. Yeah. You see, Aung San Suu Kyi only when this happened, and only after that, the demonstration is being crushed down by a violence mean, by killing, by shooting and killing many of the demonstrators. You see, what happened with U Ne Win is U Ne Win always concerned with the mediums or with the dead spirit or with witchcraft or so, no? Prophets or something like that. So what they told him was that if you still want to hang on in your power, or if you don't want to run away or just to give up your power, then you have to kill, or you have to shed blood. Huh? So after that, U Ne Win tell the people, no, at one of the national assembly. He says, the soldier never shoot into the air. They shoot at the target. Huh? So true to his words, when he ordered, no? And then soldiers kill and shoot and kill many of the demonstrators, including students and all the people, civilians. Worse is when even in the shooting at the hospital, no? When the Rangoon General Hospital, where there are so many people injured and being killed, you know? So that people who are being injured or killed, or they are taken to the hospital, the general hospital, and many people, they need blood, blood transfusion, and the doctor and nurses, they say that this hospital already full, and many are coming, and so they say, so they are shouted at the soldiers. The soldiers are on the main road, shouted at them, stop killing, don't shoot at the people, don't kill anymore, and other. So they shoot at these nurses and doctors, no? That's very, very cruel of them. No? What the way they did that, it's not. It is very inhuman. No? The soldiers, because they know. Normally, the soldiers. Now, even if it is a good soldier, no? they have their own thinking. No? They have their own mind. They have their own reason. When this happened in Rangoon, or the same thing. No? The Rangoon, they call this Miu Sao Da. Miu Sao Da is mean those soldiers who are being responsible for the security of the capital. At first, they are asked to shoot, no? but they don't shoot. They disobey the order. Because they know shooting the people, I mean shooting their own family, their own friends, maybe brothers, sisters, relatives, you know. What happened is only when this military, when this happened, they already have their own what you call the strategy. Huh? They already train people. Huh? Those notorious, no? Those young people who just grow up on the roadside and have no place to stay. Those people, they will call them and give them training, how to shoot. And then they only give them the order. Now you are soldier, you have to obey the order. If you don't disobey, you will be put in prison or you will be killed or something like that. So these people, they've been ruined on the road aimlessly, have nothing to eat, they are robbers. They are pickpocket. They pick people pocket and all they don't. All these people, when this happened, and then they are being used as to shoot. And these people, you see, they are very, very rude. The way they treat the people, even the elderly people. I was there, and I was very much disappointed and disturbed when I hear of the soldiers. They are scolding at the elderly people, the old people. Usually we respect the older people very much. Even our teachers, we talk, when we go in front of the leaders, in front of the elderly people, we have to bow or just show our respect. But these young soldiers, they don't have any sense of respecting the elderly people. The way they scold them, you can't even bear that, just hearing. It's very, very rude. Calling them names and all that, with dogs or something like that. Very, very rude. So this happened, and many people have been killed. I think that is the reason why it is difficult for the military regimes now to give up their power. See, when you came to power with bloodshed and killing, you know once you lose your power, you'll be the one. It is difficult when the... You see, when this happened, after that, then Aung San Suu Kyi came back from abroad, so to look after her mother. At the time, her mother was very sick. And then when Aung San Suu Kyi was there, then she managed to organize or talk with some of the leaders. So they formed the opposition group, the oppositions. Naturally, it is 26 years. And you feel very already fed up and tired with it under the military rule. Everybody wants freedom, And when this happened, and when after the crashing down of the democracy, Woon Ae-win says, now he will open the way for democracy, he will have election, So everybody can register any party. So I think at that time they have many parties, more than hundreds, close to 200 or something like that. There are so many small country with many parties, But Aung San Suu Kyi's and they were very keen, and they know the desire of the people. The people want a change, and people want. So he managed to get many of them under the umbrella of the NLD. So they have the National League for Democracy, and all the parties, they are under this NLD. And so when they have even when the election, the military, when the opposition group, especially the NLD, calling for election, they readily accepted that. They said okay, because they were thinking that they can win the election very easily, because they have been ruling the country for 26 years, and with one party system, with the BSPP, the Burmese Socialist Program Party. And they know if they were thinking that if their party members are stay faithful to the party, they can win very easily. Because at that level of party, they thought, and that's the reason why they just dare to have the election. Aung San Suu Kyi knew the heart of the people, because people want change. So even if the NLD was very much restricted, for election campaign, they cannot go. For election campaign, they are not free to go everywhere. You can go only to very restricted places. But you know the heart of the people, So he challenged the military, the leader for the election. And you, as you know, when the outcome of the election is the NLD won more than 80%. But when this happened again, the military, they changed their mind. Instead of giving the power to, hand over the power to the winning party, they says they will be the one to call for national convention, and they will be the one to draft the constitution. And only after this constitution was drafted and accepted, then they will hand over the power. According to them, said it will be very peaceful and everything like that. But the way the drafting of the constitution is very, it is not fair. You see, the NLD at first, they don't have any choice. Aung San Suu Kyi already told the military that drafting constitution, it is possible to finish it within 2-3 months like that. But it's now many years and nothing. Finally, they do have some of the one of the elements in the constitution that came out. But everything that is in the constitution is almost against the will of the people, and especially targeting the NLD, the opposition group. This is anyone who is being put in prison on house arrest cannot be the cannot compete in the election or cannot be the leaders. Anyone what you call worse is this is if anyone married to a foreigner cannot be the leader, the national leader, or cannot compete in the election or something like that. So it's targeting the Aung San Suu Kyi, Aung San Suu Kyi married to Michael Harris, it's a foreigner and like that. And also many of the opposition leaders, they are put in prison or house arrest and like that. And it says the number, a certain number of the member of the parliament should be appointed by the military directly, not by election. More than 10 years, but no constitution as yet. And aside from that, what they are doing is they try to get rid of the NLD. They even capture many of the leaders. So many of the opposition leaders have to run. So they are living in other countries. You see, when this happened, Aung San Suu Kyi was put in house arrest for many years. And last year, he was released in May. And this year, May again, was rearrested and put in prison again. This time is worse than before because it is a planned attack. They attack the NLD leaders and their cars and all the supporters. No one knows how many people die. The military says only 4 people die. Even that 4 people, they don't reveal their name. When the opposition call for the military leaders to give the names of those students being killed, but they don't do anything. And the reason why they refuse to allow people to see our sensitivities is very, it creates a lot of questions, a lot of suspicion in the mind of people. Some people even think whether Aung San Suu Kyi stay alive or not. But now they refuse to allow her to meet with anyone.